Hi, Dr. Najeeb. This is
Najeeb. Yes, how are you? How are you, Manuel?
Good. Yeah, I'm good. Thank you.
Yes. What can I? You know, I forgot about that. I'm taking a class. I'm looking at your hair and feeling that maybe half of that you can donate me to transplant hair. Yeah, you have beautiful hair. You have beautiful hair. Anyway, I will forget about my baldness and focus on your question. Yes, what's your question?
Yes, in the early stages, how do you distinguish if a person has insulin resistance or is it insulin deficiency, so that we can treat appropriately?
Yeah, of course. Number one reasons, even though clinical reasons are there, right? That usually type 1 diabetes in younger age and type 2 diabetes is later age. But I will go to direct and hit the bullseye. You simply check the C-peptide in the blood, right? C-peptide, if it is very low, or you check the level of insulin. You simply in the blood check the level of insulin or check the level of C-peptide, which is co-secreted with insulin. You know, insulin granules have three types of important things. Number one, they are having insulin with proinsulin. Plus, insulin granules have, of course, insulin. Plus, they have amylin. And they are having, yes, C-peptide. Again, I will repeat. Insulin granules, when beta cells are functional, when they release insulin, they not only release insulin. In equimolar amount, right, with insulin, they release C-peptide. And they also release some proinsulin. They also release amylin, right? And so, because insulin levels in the blood can be checked and C-peptide levels can be checked. If C-peptide levels are very low, now listen very carefully. If C-peptide level is very low, it means endogenous production of insulin is very low. Now, here I want to clear one concept. That sometimes it happens, someone is on exogenous insulin. Someone is taking insulin by injection. But in their patient who take the exogenous insulin, their blood does not have C-peptide. Their blood does not have C-peptide if insulin is not being produced by pancreas. So we can say that whenever insulin is present and if it is pancreatic origin, it will be accompanied by the C-peptide, which can be measured in the laboratory test in the blood. But if you come across a patient who has insulin in the blood, right, but C-peptide is very less, it means that insulin he has taken exogenous, it is not his own insulin, right? Now, we can again come another way to look at it. If you feel there's a patient who has insulin level more than normal. Now listen very carefully, Manuel James, yes. If you come across a patient that whose insulin level is normal or above normal, and that person is having diabetes, and all clinical features of diabetes, and in the blood he has hyperglycemia, and hemoglobin A1C is high, right, on different parameter. If person is diagnosed and diabetic, but if insulin is normal, that along with the C-peptide in equimolar, right, then it means he is producing insulin very well. Then why he has diabetes? Why he has chronic hyperglycemia? Why he is having, especially this high level of hemoglobin A1C? The answer is that this hyperglycemia is due to resistance, peripheral, and glucose which is present in the blood. That is number one, coming from the food. Number two, when you have low, now again, it is very important to understand, when insulin does not work on the cells' perception is as if insulin is really deficient. So what happens? Glucagon will be produced, right? And other counter-regulatory hormones will be produced. And they will activate lot of neogenic process and glycogenolytic process, and liver will start producing a lot of glucose, right? So again, I will repeat, in short, if you say, I want in one sentence answer is that if someone has diabetes and you want to be sure that diabetes is due to deficiency of insulin or not, just check the C-peptide. That's it. Thank you very much for your question.